In this video, we're looking at a tilted Atwood machine. So we have this incline with an angle of 22 degrees. There's a cart sitting on that with basically frictionless wheels, so we don't have to worry about friction in the problem. And the mass of that cart is 105 grams, so we'll need to make sure to convert that to kilograms at some point. This is tied by a string over a light and frictionless pulley to a smaller mass of 55 grams that also has to be converted to kilograms at some point in the problem. Now we have the usual goals in this problem. We want to find the acceleration of the system and the tension in the string. And then we have a little follow-up question that's a kinematics question where we want to find the distance traveled by this system in the first 0.5 seconds. So in part A, we're asked to make a complete force diagram for both of these masses, and that's actually most of the work we're going to do here. We'll start with the force of gravity on the 105 gram cart, and we can start by talking about that symbolically as mg. And note that the force of gravity always points exactly straight down. So we can plug in our numbers here. We have 105 grams, but that's 0.105 kilograms. So we just shift the decimal point 3 times. And g, that's about 9.8 meters per second squared. When we run the numbers on this, we get about 1.029 newtons, just keeping a little extra precision for the moment. The next thing we do is decompose the force of gravity into its perpendicular and parallel components in the standard way. So we start by drawing a perpendicular into the diagram. And we recall that the angle of incline for the ramp is the same as the angle between the vertical and the perpendicular. And I'll post a link at the top to the video where that was first derived. So this means the perpendicular component of gravity is given by mg cosine of theta. So there's that perpendicular component. We can draw a little dotted line here just to emphasize that what we're doing is building a right triangle, and we're just taking that adjacent side to the angle to get the perpendicular. Again, this has a magnitude of mg cosine theta. And since we already know mg, that's 1.029, we just plug in our angle. So I have times the cosine of 22 degrees. And so the magnitude of this component is about 0.9541. newtons. Now we aren't actually going to use this component of gravity in the problem, but we're doing this for the sake of the completeness of the force diagram. So we also have a parallel component of gravity, but rather than draw it down here in this right triangle, we normally attach its tail to the object itself. And the length of that guy is the length of the opposite side of this right triangle. So we're going to use the sine of our angle of inclination in order to get that. So we get this with an mg sine of theta. And again, mg is about 1.029 newtons, and we multiply that by the sine of 22 degrees. And this gives us about 0.3855 newtons. Now again, for the sake of completeness, we're going to put the normal force into the diagram. So there's our normal force, and it's pushing perpendicular to the surface of the ramp, as it always does. And the normal force is there to balance all the forces perpendicular to the surface to make sure the object stays constrained to the surface. This means our normal force also has a magnitude of mg cosine theta in order to balance that perpendicular component of gravity. So we can go ahead and write an approximate number on this. The normal force is about 0.9541 newtons. Now the reason we're not going to use this is because we don't have kinetic friction in the problem. Remember, the kinetic friction depends on the normal force. But since there's no friction in the problem, this isn't going to appear in our equations. Okay, that's almost a complete force diagram for the 105 gram mass, but we still have that string tied to it, and there's a tension in that string. So there's the tension in the string, and we don't know what it is, so this is an unknown that we'll call capital T. Now in the diagram, I was assuming the tension is big enough to pull the 105 gram mass up the ramp, but we could be wrong about that. The important thing is that we go ahead and choose our coordinate system for what the direction of acceleration is going to be in our equations. So I'm going to say that up the ramp is the positive direction. Now, if we're wrong about this, after we finish our calculations, our A is going to come out negative, so it's not a problem. It is important, though, to have a consistent definition of the positive direction. So if the 105 gram mass is going up the ramp, the 55 gram mass better be going down. So we're going to choose down as the positive direction for that 55 gram mass. So let's get into the force diagram now for the hanging mass. We start with gravity pulling down on it, and that force has a magnitude of mg. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and distinguish between our two masses by calling this m2g, and I'll change all the other ones to m1s. And we have to convert our mass to kilograms again, so that's 0.055, and g, we're still using this approximation of 9.8. And when we run the numbers on this, we get about 0.539 newtons. Now there's a second force pulling on this mass, and that's the tension in the string. And provided our pulley is light and frictionless, that's going to be the same unknown value, T. So there's our complete force diagram, and we're ready to start writing down some equations. So we're getting into part B of the problem, where we're asked to compute the acceleration of the system. Now what we do is apply Newton's second law to each moving piece of the system, and I'll start with the 105 gram piece. That's the piece we also called M1. And we've chosen a consistent coordinate system where up the ramp is positive for this guy. So we're going to call T positive, and this parallel component of gravity negative, so minus 0.3855. And that's the net force. That's the sum of all the forces acting parallel to the surface on this object. So that should be equal to the mass of the object, which is 0.105 kilograms, multiplied by its acceleration up the ramp. We do a similar thing now for the hanging mass. That's 55 grams, so we'll just label it here. And the positive direction for this, in order to be consistent with the motion of the cart on the ramp, the positive direction has to be down. So we're going to count M2g, or 0.539 newtons, as positive, and T as negative. There's your net force in the y direction for that hanging mass, and that should be equal to the mass, which is 0.055 times the acceleration. Now this is a system of two equations and two unknowns, and if I add them, the t's are going to cancel on the left-hand side. So this leaves me with 0.539 minus 0.3855 is equal to 0.16 times the acceleration. So we go ahead and do the subtraction on the left-hand side and divide by 0.16, and we've got our acceleration. And this turns out to be 0.959 meters per second squared. And we're just rounding to our traditional three significant digits there. Now in part C, we're asked to get the tension in the string, and we have a choice. We can go back to either one of the original equations that we wrote down using Newton's second law and plug in A and then solve for T. So the only question is which one of those is easier to work with. And I think the top one is slightly easier because I can quickly solve for the tension by adding this 0.3855 to both sides. So T is 0.3855 plus 0.105 times A, but A we now know is 0.959 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers on this, we get a tension of 0.486 newtons. Finally, we're asked to compute the distance traveled in the first 0.5 seconds. So this is just a constant acceleration kinematics question. If we say we're talking about the cart here, we can call the initial position 0, the initial velocity 0 because it's released from rest, and we're just subbing into our standard kinematics equation that describes position as a function of time. So that's x equals x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. So we're calling our initial position 0, the initial velocity 0, and this simplifies to just 1/2 at squared. And all we have to do is sub in our acceleration. So I have 1/2 times 0.959 meters per second squared for the acceleration times 0.5 seconds all squared. Again, because we just want to know how far it moves in the first half second. So when we run the numbers on this, we end up with 0.1199 meters. And I want to round this off to three significant digits, but I also want to express it in centimeters because it just feels like a more natural unit here. So this is going to round to 12.0 centimeters if we keep our usual three significant digits. Now, if you're interested in seeing what this problem looks like, if we keep it purely symbolic, in other words, if all I had was M1 and M2 and an incline angle of theta, I'll post a link to that video at the upper left of the end screen. At the lower left of the screen, you'll see a playlist of similar dynamics problems. Thanks for watching.